Hi, it's John Wanoa here again on the East Cape of the North Island, New Zealand. I'm here with Desmond today, my nephew, and we're just filming the rising of the sun, the most easterly part of the world, and the shortest distance to the sun. But it's an overcast day today, so it spoiled the impact of the sun coming out of the sea. We've got a big black cloud in front of it. So, nevertheless, we're here, and it took some effort to get up the steps. They've fixed them up, they've modified the steps and put more steps in to make 800 steps altogether, which is quite something that makes it a bit easier to get up the steps. But anyway, we've still got our camera focused on the cloud over there just to see the sun come up. That's what we've come here. I've come all the way from Auckland to Gisborne to Rotorua to Rangitukia to have three meetings. And in Te Araroa as well with Gilbert Walker. So we're going to have a meeting with him on his C4, Marangaro C4 block, backing onto Haha block. So we'll have a little bit of talk about anything we're doing out this way just to let them know that we're intending putting the tidal turbines out here on Ranfurly Bay. So I've got to get all the engineers' reports in. And I wanted to do this on Rangitukia, on the mouth of the river. So I have to go to Tumutumu Pairoa and apply to have a lease on that property. If it's half, if it's the whole lot, I'll take the whole lot to develop it for the shareholders, about 250 shareholders on that land. I was talking to Mano Raroa yesterday. I'm not very happy with him, he's not very happy with me. So I'm just letting the public know, and the shareholders on that land block, we have intentions to put a few things in there for you, and you'll be running it yourselves in the local community, because I'm just organising as much as possible the funding for any projects that we do on the East Coast. Okay, so I'm working in with Waitangi, with those hapus up there, and also the hapu down here. We're on heading A12 block next to Leslie and Richard. But we're next to them, and we were talking to them yesterday, at least Leslie. We're quite happy at this stage to see them again if we are granted the lease, take over the lease. That block to make that our base for these operations out here in the sea. We've done a few years of extensive research right through these land blocks, and that's my role as real estate to make sure we comply with international law, British law, and also the laws of New Zealand. And so we're getting that in order. Desmond's picking up quite a bit of information from me to share with the local community there, because we'll have lots to do and to make a start after all these years. And we're not one that's left out for all this time because of funding that prevents us from going on our land parks and doing something. And most of the lands got dairy on it, dry stock, sheep, and we could do with some other things other than bees on it, and we want to introduce some of the older industries they had before, including deep sea fishing and also the energy projects that we're hoping to install over time. That's a big project in itself, but we just want to get our feet in the ground first and form our executive committee for that on a trust, as a trustee, on heading a A12 block. Glad to say we've got past the first stage of using that block for the shareholders, about 45 shareholders in that block, and also work with the past leases of the block once it expires in about October. What was their name again, Desmond? Leslie
Richard
and
Richard. Leslie Fisher.
Oh, Fisher. That's what I was. Got the name. I just wanted to make sure I'm addressing them as our neighbours, or we're the new ones coming aboard. got plenty of experience to share with them and to make things work for everyone. So we're not there just for ourselves, we're there for the families to make good the land. So we're waiting for sun to come up. It's taking its time. As you can see, it's starting to get daylight at about 7 o'clock now. And I'll just leave the film on for a little bit longer. You can see it just rising now, that red spot there. And we've had a good run in the last day or two, Des and I. It's been a few years we've been working together. And he's been dedicated to what our role is as responsible landowners with a new vision to share with everyone. And so we're hoping to get something going by the end of this year. And morning. He's brave to come up, the stairs after I've been up the stairs. just have a visitor come up and they're fit, these people. I'm glad I got up the stairs. But anyway, we're watching the sun come up. That was the whole purpose of this. Good morning. we're waiting for the sun to come out, but it's taking its time. And the clouds are in the way. Where have you come from?
Germany.
Germany. Oh, welcome to New Zealand. We're the tame natives. Right. Oh, it's a long time. I'm just trying to get the glow from the sun, but it's a bit hidden. How long are you in New Zealand for? Oh, okay. That's good. Oh, going home soon. What do you think of the weather? You think the weather?
Well, sometimes great, but sometimes lots of rain.
Right, the rain spoils. Right. Morning. Another brave one comes up the stairs. 800 stairs. We're here. We're in New Zealand. This is where we live here. But we're just filming the sun after all these years. Yeah, the bad day. Yeah, I didn't think it was going to turn out like this. Yeah. Where else have you been? Oh yeah. What do you think of there? It's nice. Yeah. Now you got to go back to Germany and take some memories with you from here. We're right out of the way of harm's way. We're right away from everybody, in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. This is Desmond and I'm John. There he comes. He's just about. It's spectacular when it's really comes up out of the water when it's clear. I'll just let it go for another couple of minutes or so and then we'll take off. It's just coming on daylight now, 10 minutes past 7 in the morning. On Wednesday, 28th of June, 2016, John Monod. I just want to just finish this video. I'll just have it trained on the sun there while I'm talking. So far, we've booked our followers on Facebook and YouTube. Desmond and I did this. We're just putting some plans together for Waitangi. We'll be going up to Waitangi. We have another meeting next month around about the 13th of July to raise our flag, raise the 1835 Declaration of Independence flag with the Kingi and the Chiefs this time around. So the last time we opened up the Marae, the Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, now officially put the flag up and give John Key notice of our intentions to enforce the laws of that flag straight to Britain. Now that Brexit is in and Britain pull out of the EU Parliament, we've got our contract with the flag direct to Britain, as it was, as it is now, in our partnership business. And that's why we want to get these projects going for the record, for the British military watching this video. John Manoa here and Desmond, my nephew, are working on a plan to go to England, to Westminster, to raise our flag there, and also to raise it on King William's estate land in Devon, England, in William Yard, next to his memorial, and to raise it next to Maui statue, our Tahitian ancestral inheritance title in Queen Elizabeth's Great Court in London. So that'll give us definition and substance to our titles here. Sun rising, Ra in the east, has been the first point of the time clock title at 6 a.m. in the morning, and Te Pito here on Haha Block, just to my right, and also at 6 a.m., 6 p.m. in London, and also in Ghana, Africa. The Kingdom of Ghana is 6 p.m., and on East Island, Rapa Nui, it's 12 midday. The 3 points of the sun here, shining at the same time on those 3 points of Earth, on a triangle, as a square, a mirror image triangle, inside a circle, perfected title. So that's what I'm saying here today, is to establish our title, which is Ra, the sun, God, Earth God, to London, and to King William IV, our partner in this commerce business flag, and also our protection from the British to come here on our landlocks with us, protect our interests in the sea bed of the Pacific Island and New Zealand, to Britain, England and Wales, now that Scotland and Ireland has left England and Wales, split off and gone to the EU Parliament. We now have only Britain, two state plus ours, plus New Zealand and Pacific Islands, or Aotearoa New Zealand and Pacific Islands as a third partner. Third state, country, and our flag will pick up the 250 countries to join us in that partnership. So, once again, to everyone watching this video, from Desmond and I, we're just waiting for the sun to just solidify the date today, being the 28th of June 2016, that we have establishment of ourselves as being the man on the land, people, the native of New Zealand, to British, our contract partners, private contract partners in Admiralty, of the sea, and also the 8-point star of the St. Patrick's Order as our title in Westminster, to return back from here to Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, to take back our findings here, and to put it on the record from Waitangi Marae and the Chiefs and Kingi Tauroa straight to England, straight to Britain, UK Parliament and Government. And now that we've got this, Sun has got a sad look on his face today, not very bright, but however, that's the way he came out today, not very happy, but that's our film to establish our links to Britain in the new Britain, England, Wales, and Aotea, New Zealand. To all you people watching around the world on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Google, this is John Wanoa from the East Cape, North Island, New Zealand, on our land blocks, native title here, Jason and I, bidding you a nice day today. Thank you very much. We'll see you in Waitangi. Now, we have a crowd here today, this morning. People have come up and walked those stairs, 800 of them now, it used to be 600, well, I'm 67 today. 600?
It says 800.
Oh, it says 800, yeah. So, I pat myself on the back because I'm, I've managed to get up the hill at my age. Yeah, yeah, to get up and come up the stairs, yeah. You want to be on film? Okay, that's all right. I'm just spinning the rest of the film. Desmond, pick my bag up, we're going down and I'll film on the way down. You have a nice day. Enjoy yourself and you'll stay here by the last days. Meanwhile, we've just got to live with it here. Come on, mate, we'll go. See you later. Have a nice day. So we're going down the stairs now. I thought I'll just keep the film rolling. Won't take long to get down. What's the time, Desmond? And we'll see how long it takes to get down.
7 o'clock.
It's 7 o'clock now, but we're just going to make our way downstairs. I just want you to follow this stairway all the way down. I just want to film the C12 block, Marangaro C12 block, in the background there. So you can see it's flat, more or less, it's only about 1.5 meters above sea level. And so that's very low. And it's like a flooded plain there, a bit boggy. Morning. Brave people coming up the stairs. Morning. Enjoy your day.
Thank you, you too.
So there we go. That's we want to develop this, but that will come later now. I want to do a lot of the aqua farms. We have got a permission to put aqua farms on the front end of that block there, in a papakainga, which is a little village of houses. But we're going to put that on hold until we get the other block in Ruatoria going, Port Awanui. This one here is a major. It's got drainage problems and bog problems, boggy. But we're going down the stairs and left at 7 o'clock. I want to see how long it takes to get down. I'm not going to count them because she's already got everything on the bottom. And so I might count too many. Add some more. Right, we're going down. Guess we're having a laugh. So we're going to go to our meeting in Rangitukia, and with Tamati Reid, tell him the good news about yesterday, and tell him the good news about Rotorua. I'm excited. I'm excited for the first time in at least 50 years. I get to do something and share with Desmond a project that he's been longing to wait for. Waiting, and lots of people waiting. All they say, when. But this is what the track looks like. So I hope you like this video of the view when we come out into the open over here. That's what I wanted to do. I wanted to do this. I knew I had a bit of film to do it. So I'll spend the whole film on it and talk at the same time. But the legs are doing well. The gym has been very good to my legs, stretching them around. And I'm doing alright so far. It's puffing like anything coming up the stairs. Just don't trip over. Be careful. There's no ambulance around here. I got a Fitbit on my hand, look. My girl's bought it. Catherine. She'll be interested. Yeah, so the Fitbit, I'm going to put it on Wi-Fi so that if my blood pressure goes too high. It did pretty well coming up this hill. Mind you, I'm telling the whole world about my blood pressure. Makes me do it, that's all. Keeps me fit. do what I say. Right. We got a sea, the block. See? I'm filming all these steps so you can see on YouTube. My mate's following behind me just in case I fall over. He'll pick me up by the hair and stand me up. Off we go. So far, so good. He hasn't had to put on the emergency cap and. Yeah. Once again, I'm very excited today to be up with Desmond to go and have a little survey. We're going to come back again if we're successful. We're not through the water, through the woods yet, until we get the answer back from the Maryland. But it's like any other property that's in Maryland ownership. It has to get approval and put an application in for to be the trustee of the Heringa A12 block. And so we're going to follow that through its paces, and it'll give us a good opportunity to manage a bit of land, the first one in so many years, and then improve from there. It's a learning curve of business, and I want to apply skills that I've had for some years into the block and help the young ones to make do out of the block. Very good exercise, and so much to do. I love the fishing and diving, that'll be exciting. But we're getting near the bottom now, and we're still rolling this film, and we've got some nice breakfast to have at Tamati's. I've got some turnip tops, which I call shomalia, and mixed with corned beef. I hope he's got some pumpkins or something to go with it. Kamakamos. Normally they've got nice gardens, local stuff. Now we're coming near the bottom, so you can see the block out there, and the amount of erosion of that seabed out there is 60-70 meters gone of land. Has been wiped out because of the erosion, and the government has not done anything about fixing it, because there's been no money, not enough generated from this land. That's the house there for this block. I think that house came from the other house on the other side, the goldsmith's house on the other side there. That came from the Whanaukina Island, and they bought it here and put it over there. We have some issues with the land at this stage. So the front half of that block, I've got a permission from the trustees to put aquafarms, so we'll hold that one off once we get funding for that. We can start there, but it's not going to sort of half start and half finish. We've got to try and get the whole thing done. But we'll start small first on the other block in Pretoria. So there we go. We've got a good shot of the front end of Maringaro C12 block. And goes back through there, goes all the way back, and the fence line's over there, and goes all the way back to Haha that way. All that ridge along there, the Pito is beyond that point there, on the other side, halfway along to Rangitoto. That's the part we're interested in one day, not yet. So, we've got our intentions for there, but in the meantime, it's about the stairs. We're looking at the stairs, 800 stairs. All you people in the world, all these tourists upstairs, a whole heap of them, came up to see the sun come up, but they just missed it. And got there, and it was trying to get out. So it's a bit dismal. not to see it in its magnificent form. However, we've been here and seen the sunrise on a day like this. We're running out of steps soon. We've still got a fair way to go. And I'm just trying to think of something else to talk about while we're about this. So we're talking with Tamati Reid today in his Kiwi party. We'll get to Rangituki here and see what that's about. Also with what we're talking about before in the last meeting, we'll just update it and see what more they've got to add. But generally they're waiting for some pūtea or funding for any projects. So, now I'm puffing going downhill. I'm puffing like anything going uphill. Anyway, we're at the bottom. Shortly, you've never seen so many steps in all your life to get up to the lighthouse. Some of them have been added by the looks of the last time I was up here. It was about 3 years ago. Now I'm starting to run downhill. Is he getting out now? Now you can see a better shot of the farm block. That's one where Dave Desmond and I are owners in. It goes along to that shed over there. Fence line goes up the hill across there. So, you want to say something? No, he doesn't want to say something. He's okay. It's about the stairs. Today, we came here specifically to climb these stairs. Put it on the record. We conquered this mountain. And all our intentions and dreams of doing things conquered. A bit at a time. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. This is wonderful. Look, the trees all the way down. 150, look, 150. It says 150. That's 150 from there down. And the rest is about 750 up from there. Makes 800. There you go, Jamie. This is what you missed out on, coming out to see the sun. It wasn't bright this time. Coming back again. Yeah, I might want to come back next time. But that's what it looks like. If you can get up this hill, you'll be doing all right, but you better count the steps before you attempt to get up this hill. Anyway, Jason and I having a nice day. We're going to go along the beach, have a look if there's any crayfish dancing around on the rocks. Got my dive gear. But we'll think about that when we get there. We've got a meeting to go to soon, so looks like we might run out of time. Maybe next time, diving. I left some gear behind. I want to go out in the ocean and get some big canoes. Nice lunch today. We got some mussels at least anyway. Okay, we're at the bottom. Now people, we've conquered the mountain. And we are now going out past the house, the local house here. Back to the car. Whew. There! How's that? Don't slip over, John. Don't break your neck. So far, so good. I'll be very careful. Now don't go back in the ambulance. That's what this Fitbit's for. And there's no ambulance down here. So no. They wanted to take me to the hospital because my blood is too high. But however, it's all right. And there we go. We're down the bottom of the hill. And we'll go back to Rotorua ticketing now. And back to Gisborne. We'll go back to Auckland in the morning. And back to work. So, from me, John. Good evening. We'll see you later. There, there's the bog there. So you see all this along here is boggy because it's swamped. No good for houses in here. It's going to put our farms in there because if a tsunami came in, it would just come straight through here. That's what I'm saying. It's no good for anything else but aqua farms. Now you can expect a tsunami to be blown in here anytime. Once you get a big surge or a volcano, they're starting to blow now. If that happens, you can expect this place to get flooded because it's only 1.2 metres above sea level. I've did a measurement over there and where I want to put things, but they'll be high off the ground. In this area, there's a lot of money to spend in this property. The same at Rangitiki, there's a lot of money to spend upgrading the roadbed and the mouth. And that's what Manu Raro missed out on yesterday. He didn't want anybody, he said it's his land. And there's 250 shareholders he's forgotten about. So that's something I'm going to discuss with the trustees, the Tumutumu Paeroa and the Marin Trust and the Marin Bank. I'll discuss with them about that. So from me, John, here, that's the sign. You can have a bit of read what it says about the lighthouse. Lighthouse access. Access to the lighthouse passes through private land. Please respect privacy of the people living here. Visitors using staff steps do so at their own risk. Please take care. Camping is not permitted. So that's me and Desmond. We're off to Rangitiki now. See you later and have a nice day.